frown that needs to be turned upside down. You should call Sam Chevelle, private detective.
Hi, I'm Sam. Sam Chevelle, private detective. And boy, do I have a doozy of a case. And by doozy, I mean if I was using a sliding scale, rounding to the nearest whole number, of course, this would come in at a solid, 3. You see, I was at my grocery store. I was picking up, bread, banana, protein powder, when I decided to peruse my favorite section to find new cases, aka the tabloid section. And there it was, in between my grandpop's an alien and my socks can sing Phantom of the Opera. Although the socks thing did catch my eye, what really got my attention was this. Dead man is alive. Now I realize the preposterousness of this situation. I mean, how can you be both dead and alive? What kind of case was this? Was this the case of a bad coroner? The case of a good game of possum? Or the case of something different? I guess those are the three options. Well, I decided while I was in the checkout line that I was gonna buy some Tic Tacs. But I also decided I was gonna get to the bottom of this case. But how? Well, I figured I'd start where I normally do, at the end. It's much easier that way, and you usually win. That article I just threw over my shoulder referred to a well-known skeptic in the area. Apparently, he saw the dead man walking and had a few things to say. Now that's called perfect timing. Or reading the script, whatever floats your boat. Hello?
Hi, I'm Thomas.
Good for you.
You asked me to come.
I did.
I'm doubting, Thomas.
Oh, well, come on in, doubting.
You know, that whole doubting thing is...
Exactly what I'm looking for. Take a seat. That seat. That one right there, your seat.
Okay.
So, doubting Thomas. I hear you were a witness to something that sounds pretty unbelievable.
Yeah, you can say that again.
If you insist. I hear you were witness to something that sounds pretty unbelievable.
I assume you're talking about Jesus.
Am I?
Aren't you?
Excuse me. Well, this guy is as confused as a pencil with two erasers. Or a boomerang that just flies straight. I mean, come on, just use a stick. But his momentary lapses of confusion aren't going to stop me, because little does he know that's the world I live in. So, pouting Thomas. The dead man was Jesus?
Yeah, I mean, it says so right here.
Well, I didn't read the article, just the headlines and the pictures. Do I look 30 to you? Let's just stick to the facts. You're telling me Jesus died?
Yeah. I mean, tons of people saw it. He was killed. It was horrible.
Well, you're saying that all these people saw Jesus die and that you saw him doing the Tel Aviv two-step?
Yes.
Give me a moment. Well, I thought this guy was a skeptic. Some kind of cynic, if you will. And with a name like Shouting Thomas, I also expected a little more gusto. But he seems like he would believe in anything. Bigfoot, Loch Ness Monster, good football team in Cleveland. Well, that might happen. I did have just one more question for him. I've got one more question for you. Sprouting
yeah.
Thomas. Why do they call you that?
They don't. They call me Doubting Thomas.
Oh.
Yeah, like I said, after Jesus died, a few days later, he came to a bunch of his followers and made an appearance, and unfortunately, I wasn't there.
So you say?
No, I really wasn't there. So, you know, when people started telling me that Jesus was alive, I told them I needed to see him and touch him and feel him in order to know that he was really alive.
Yeah, and how'd that go for you, Mr. Touchy-Feely?
Well, a few days later, I got my shot. Jesus reappeared, and he looked straight at me, and he said, "Thomas, take your finger and put it in my hand. Reach out your hand and put it in my side. Stop doubting and believe." So I guess, in a way, Jesus kind of gave me the nickname.
Well, I guess it's better than my nickname in middle school, Spam Chevelle.
Yeah. So anyway, after I saw Jesus, of course I believed. Jesus said, "You have seen me, so you believe. And blessed are those who have not seen me, but still believe."
Wow.
Yeah, you know, after Jesus died, I wasn't sure that anything good would ever happen again. I'm telling you, I couldn't have been more wrong. See, once Jesus died and I knew he'd come back to life, that gave me hope that good can come out of any situation.
Even the situation of my nickname?
Yeah, something like that. So, hey, if it's okay, I think I probably should be going. I hope.
Yeah, thanks, Scouting Thomas, but I really didn't need any help with this one. It was open shut. Another successful case in the books. But what about my next group? You're still here.
Yeah. So, I guess I'll just be going.
Yeah, you do that. Bye-bye. Well, I'm glad I could set that guy straight. Going through life like some kind of Doubting Thomas is a sad way to be. Well, on to more important things, like the case of the Tic Tacs. Are they candy, are they mint, or are they something else entirely? I'm Sam. Sam Chevelle. Sam. Keep digging, everybody.
Imagine for just a second if you had an opportunity to actually see Jesus, to actually be able to touch Jesus the way that Thomas was. Now, obviously, we don't have that opportunity, and we have to just believe and understand and see those stories and recognize that Jesus wasn't frustrated or even mad at Thomas. He just recognized that he had doubts and wanted to help confirm those in his mind and begin to bring an answer to that. And so in your life and in my life, Jesus is okay if we have questions, if we have doubts, if we have concerns. He wants us to bring those to him. And in those moments, he wants to help the days or the situations that are going bad. He wants us to have hope because of the fact that he was able to defeat death. He can bring something good out of any situation that we find ourselves in. So whatever's going on in your life, if there's something that's not going well, lean into the fact that Jesus defeated death and came back to life, and recognize that that same power is available to you and I in whatever situation we're going through, and that God will walk us through that situation and turn something bad into something good. Let's review the life app one more time. Will you say it with me? Hope, believing that something good can come out of something bad. Let's pray. Jesus, thank you so much for the way that you dealt with Thomas in the middle of his doubt, that you didn't kick him out, that you didn't run him off, you didn't tell him he was dumb, you just walked him through that process. Would you help us to recognize that in the middle of situations that are maybe not what we would hope they would be, would you give us hope to believe that you can do something good out of something that seems so bad? Thank you for your love for us and your patience with us. This month, as we celebrate the fact that you defeated death, would you help us to trust that, and would you help us to lean into that as we look at any situation that we're going through where we just desperately need your presence? Thank you again for this morning. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, thanks. Enjoy the rest of the morning.